Today, we're going to cover chapters 12 and 13 in 1 Corinthians. He begins to talk about spiritual gifts and spiritual functions in the church. Paul is saying, concerning spiritual gifts, I don't want you to be ignorant. You see, as God's people, as believers, we should not only know, but be trained and be equipped in the exercising of these spiritual gifts. And this is true for all of us. Not just for the pastors or for those in ministry. This is for all believers. Our God manifests himself. And he manifests himself through his people. And that's what the gifts of the Holy Spirit are. They are the manifestations of the Holy Spirit. They're expressions. God is speaking, God is working through his people by his Spirit. The expression of the gifts may be varied. That's what the same gifts are expressed differently through all of us. The manifestation of the Spirit is given to each one for the profit of all, so that everybody can benefit from it. If you have the Holy Spirit, or better still, if the Holy Spirit has you, then you have all the nine gifts. So after talking about spiritual gifts that are available to us as believers, he now moves on to talk about our spiritual function. He baptized us, he immersed us, he submerged each one of us. He baptized all of us into the body. So God paid attention to each one of us. He's saying, look, he has set each one in the body just as it pleased him. God put you there because he saw it fit and he was pleased in putting you in that place. He designed you for it. He gave you what it takes for you to be in that place. We are not all designed to be the same. Now you got to get involved. You got to become a part of the body. That's what the local church is. It's to be a body where we, each one of us, is a part, is a member, and we are needed in the body. We are not independent. We need each other. We need each other. Every member of the body, we need each other. God has placed each one where he saw it best for us, just as he was pleased. So there is a place for you in the body. And it's a place where God says, that's the best place for you. And it pleases me for you to be in that place. There's a place for you. And if you're committed to this local church, it means you have a place, you have a function in the body. Some of you may be empowered to be business people. That's okay. Some of you may be empowered to be scientists. Some of you may be empowered to be, designers. Whatever. There is grace on your life to do whatever God's called you to do. It's grace. And you can grow in grace. But more grace comes by using the grace you already have. While he's talking about gifts and spiritual functions, he's talking about walking in love. Whatever you do, whatever you and I do in exercising the gifts, we must be governed, we must be guided, we must be motivated by love. So when you're serving God, when you're serving people, let love be the motivation. Are you with me? God, I love that person. That's why I'm willing to take risk. That's why I'm willing to, minister by the power of the Spirit. That's why I'm willing to press in. Why? Because I love the person. Let love motivate you to manifest the gifts, to express the gifts, and to fulfill your function. It's not a duty. It's not a job. It's a love thing. It's a motivation by love. Amen? So, three simple statements. Walk in love. Desire spiritual gifts. Step out in love.